Hello, 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 generals! Welcome to another my video where I describe you great games and with my tips and tricks to you be successful in those great games. So, to not making too much big this video, I prepared in this video specially just tips and tricks and guides and advice for game called Empires and Allies. So I've written on paper those tips and tricks, and you must know that those tips and tricks I didn't mention in my other videos of this game, so I tried to, in each video will be to be different tips and tricks, so to me do not repeat myself, so to say. So in this video I prepared many tips and tricks, and before we start, I wanted to tell you that this game, I advise you to do not play this game on Facebook Game Room, because Facebook Game Room will be shut down soon in few weeks, so who knows what will happen with your progress in this game. So try to play this game only on mobile devices. It is still playable on those devices. I'm there very much stronger than on this Facebook Game Room. I only intentionally want to play on Facebook Game Room mostly because to record videos, but unfortunately Facebook Game Room will be shut down. But it is really, really nicely done also on mobile devices. So if you want to start playing it, play on mobile devices. And so on. Okay, so I have, if you probably you've seen that I have few other videos about this great game. In few videos I show you how to be successful in attacking other players and how to successfully defend your base, and also all these videos are different with different tips and tricks, so I advise you if you want to check them out on my channel IGRimen Gaming. And also I tried also in review first video of this great game to put tips and tricks that I hope so didn't mention in other videos of this great game. Okay, so let me get started to I show you tips and tricks that I prepared for this video. I will try to make more videos with this great game until I explain every part of it, I hope so. Okay, so sorry for not putting music and sound because it is very loud and I want you to hear me very good. Unfortunately, you cannot lower the sound in game music, so to say. Okay, so let's get started. So for example, this is, we have Omega unit, as you know, and I advise you to only put Omega unit to defend your base is only if you have a lot of resources, so to enemy do not take your resources, for example. But there is trick, you can always use this boost, for example, defensive to use, here we are, defense shield to make. You can always make defense shield, but it only lasts 12 hours. So if you go, you know you will not be online for some long time, I advise you to put defense Omega unit to defend your base to enemy do not take your all your resources. But I advise you, as I said, to only put to defend if you have a lot of resources to defend, because it is very, very hard to repair Omega unit. So I only advise you to use it if you have resources a lot to enemy do not take it. Otherwise, there is nothing less to protect if you have low resources. Okay, so let's put him to sleep. We don't want it to defend. In my other videos I describe you how successfully defend your base and how successfully to attack, so I will not telling you these tips and tricks. Just watch my other video and I hope so it will be useful and helpful. Okay, so let's continue. Then we have something very interesting that I discovered also from other videos of other makers of videos of this great game, is that is to do not, if you play this game, I advise you to finish as much as you can missions to unlock whole map, but do not unlock literally every part of game, because for example I seen in video of my colleague gaming YouTuber that he told to do not unlock this part of map, for example. I think this will be your last to unlock and finish map. So why? Because just leave that part, do not finish those missions, because on these parts will spawn new players and you can farm them as much as you can. So do not finish all missions on map. For example, I talking about farming players like this. So I didn't finish these missions that is next. So game put me players like this, for example, that I can attack also. So if you finish all missions on map, then game will not show you players that you can attack. So I advise you to do not finish all missions. Just leave 3 or 4 missions, as I seen at my colleague YouTube gaming YouTuber. He left just Australia open, didn't finish missions, so too he can farm players that spawn over time. Over some time they spawn new players, and so you can attack them as much as you can, and to do not attack them with this thing, this part of game. So just leave few missions and everything will be fine. Okay, so next what I wanted to tell you. So next tips and tricks. Let's get back to here. So next is save your gold. So for example, I wanted to tell you, I told you in other my video that firstly, if you collected enough gold, do not spend the gold at all until you build engineer this building, because you will upgrade a lot of things, you will have a lot of resources from attacking players. So you must buy this engineer as fast as you can, and don't worry, you can buy it, you can collect enough gold in just 1 or 2 weeks for sure. It doesn't take too much longer, because you, if you attack players in those 1 or 2 weeks very often, you will get also very nice achievements that give you gold, and also you will be in ranked very high in event and also get gold. So very soon you can get this and buy engineer, so you can buy and so you can upgrade 2 buildings at the same time. So save gold, if you start playing this game, save gold to buy this engineer, you must have it. It is not so expensive in gold. And then what I wanted more to tell you about gold, I advise you to do not spend gold on anything and save gold for buying these babies, Elite Cash Crate or whatever you want to call it, because you need these quantum cores to get for to unlock this baby purple cores, to get stronger omega units, to unlock stronger omega unit. Here we are. What I mean, here we are. They are a little stronger than regular blue omega unit. So only you really use of spending gold is to get those purple points to unlock purple omega unit. So save your gold to just open and buy this cash, Elite Cash for gold. Okay, so you to get those quantum cores. Also you will get very nice things. There is high chance you to get very, very nice things. So that is the real meaning to save gold. Also, as you know, you can destroy trees for gold, but I don't advise you. I describe you why I advise you to not destroy trees in my other video. So you, if you destroy tree, you can get some gold, not too much. And if you, for example, eat, if it is big tree like this, you will get the most gold. But I really don't advise you. You will have gold, as you can see how much I have gold here. I didn't spend any money in this game, and I have, as you can see at my right corner, upper corner, I have over 1,000 gold, because mostly is from events, because I always was first in 3 ranked. Okay, so next tips and tricks, just to look on my paper, please wait. Then let's go to starting to describe you building war factory. So here we are. You have war factory, and I advise you that these points that you get from your clan's request, let's request from our clan. I advise you first of all to join very active clan. It is very, very important to be in active clan. If you join some clan and it is not active, just leave it, because you need resources and help to speed up upgrades and to get resources, to request resources, and to get also these points here from your allies in your clan. So I advise you to find very, very active clan to help you, and also to very often send you reinforcements. I mean, of these reinforcements, I will tell you tips and tricks about reinforcements later, just to finish War Factory tips. So in War Factory, best thing is to spend points is on this elite cash, of course, because you can get purple omega points. Elite cash, I advise you, or maybe if you're most likely to wait to collect more points to get component cash. But I really didn't see too much use of component cash. For me, it is best elite cash, and it doesn't cost too much points you collected from allies that send you. So don't worry, just you can use this, of course. And especially, I advise you to do not wait to unlock, for example, this building, because there is nothing really, there is not good defense in this game. So no matter how strong your defense is, enemy can almost surely defeat you. I made how to defend successfully, but there is no perfect defense in this game. So really do not spend, just look how much points it is needed to buy this building. So, and also it is very important why it is not good to spend those hard earned points, because you can most of these buildings build on your own, and boost you can build on your own. For example, this boost cost, as you can see, 360, and you can buy these guard tower rockets. You can buy it, for example, to build. You can build them. So here we are. You can build them and just see how much ridiculous amount of it is needed to build. So why you to spend points that is very, very hard to get so much points when you can use better those points, for example, buying elite cash. Okay, so what I wanted more to tell you while we are here. So defense shield is very good to always have ready if you have a lot of resources to activate. To enemy do not take your resources. For example, if you have a lot of resources and you didn't finish all upgrades of your buildings, and you will need more resources and more time to other upgrades finished. So just use defense shield, and when you get online, you can start upgrade of other buildings. Then, while we are here, what I wanted to more tell you, stealth generation, you must always have activated in your base, because to enemy think you are not activated Omega unit, and to hide your headquarters and your defense structures. I described that in my other video, so do not explain myself again, just watch that video. I describe you everything about it, why it is important stealth generator. Then, for example, Patriot is very nice also to have, but like I said, if you have a lack of components, this I don't advise you to build, because there is not perfect defense in this building, in this defense against attacker, so don't worry about it too much to defend your city. You will have always a lot resources if you attack players all the time. And also by attacking players, you will also be very high ranked in tournaments. Also, it is very important here, bonus command points. You must build this to increase amount of command points in battles. But there is trick I explained you. You can increase your command points also by here we are. So by dragging strike force to the command center. But it, as you can see, it lasts only 50 minutes, while in War Factory it lasts, here we are, it lasts for one day. So it is very important this, and it doesn't cost too much to build, so I advise you highly to use this and build all the time when you are in game, because it is very important that bonus command points to have in battle, because it really easily you will easily more defeat players. Okay, so I hope so you understood me good. This is very important, bonus command points always to have. It doesn't cost too much, and always activate it, and you will have 10 command points to spend in battles for one day, literally one day you can use it. Okay, so let's just I see on my paper, do I tell you some other tips and tricks? Okay, so let's go War Factory. I describe you. Then something interesting, for example, if you maybe didn't know, in rally flag you can choose to your troops start moving to other rally flags, or to they be still. For example, here we are, these troops, here we are. If you put them, click them here, they will start moving from each rally point and return to its own rally point. So I advise you to put them to they move, because it is very harder for enemy with orbital strikes and tomahawks to hit them while they're moving, and also while they're moving through your base, they can easily find enemies to attack. So it is very nice things to you have them moving. But some parts of map you defend of your base doesn't require to you move them, and it is better to they will be still. So for example, I wanted troops to be here all the time and here all the time. And also you can as bait make them as bait, so to enemy attack them. Okay, so next thing what I wanted more to tell you. Yes, so for example, let's go farther with more tips and tricks and guides, advice. Okay, so next thing, before, this is very important. I'm very weak on this account. On my other account, I'm very stronger because I like this game a lot on my mobile devices. And it is proven So I wanted to tell you that it is proven very good tactic to do not level up your headquarters until you level up, literally level up all your other buildings. So level up, upgrade, so to say, upgrade all your buildings. And if you have nothing left to upgrade, or anything up to upgrade any more buildings, then just go to next level headquarters, next level. Why is this important? Because you need to be prepared for next level, because stronger players and stronger enemies and will attack you and so on. So you need to be prepared with defense, with your other upgrades, with, for example, this troop squads to be upgraded, and also research. So not just upgrade your buildings before you level up, just also you need to upgrade your research to maximum level. And I advise you to firstly upgrade those troops that you use in attacking players. So do not spend oil on some troops, for example, like this, that you do not use in attacking players, because it is very, very hard at higher level to start upgrades. So just level up all troops that you use, and especially command powers. I advise you first to upgrade troops that you use, because they will mostly benefit. Then upgrade, after you finish upgrading to maximum level troops that you use in attacking players, then upgrade all your command powers to maximum level. And later you can focus on base defense. For example, for me it is only left this, which will start now, to upgrade. So you can use to upgrade base defense if you have enough oil. But nothing really is to get from those upgrades, because, as I said, it is very hard to defend. And also, for example, what I wanted to tell you, it doesn't cost too much to upgrade those defense, base defense, so you will have also to finish that easily. So after you upgrade all buildings, after you upgrade all your researches, then you can start to level up your headquarters and to be ready for next level and for next stronger players and so on and so on. Okay, so what I wanted more to tell you. Yes, while we are here, I wanted to tell you which buildings, after you level up headquarters, you will have a lot options to upgrade your buildings and to build new buildings. So first of all, what is most important first to upgrade and build when you level up your headquarters? Most important is first to build buildings that you unlock here. So you must first build them and upgrade first 3 or 4 levels, because it doesn't cost too much money and too much time. And then what is next most important upgrade of buildings you must do? And that is first upgrade this baby, this storage bunker, because as you can see, it hide your resources, so to enemy do not take all your resources from your base. Then upgrade weapons command. Here we are. It is why it is important to next building you upgrade, or 2 buildings at same time. You can upgrade this and previous building that I described you, because you will get command points +1, as you can see. Then upgrade, for example, then upgrade research agency, so you can unlock more research to upgrade your troops, as I showed you before. So it is very, this is third third building to you need to upgrade the in that order. Then next to upgrade is war factory, so you to unlock more building, more things you can build there. Then next is what is most important is this troop building, because higher level, as you know, troop means you can hold more troops of same kind. For example, you will not see effect if you are, for example, level 13 like this, and to upgrade to next level you will not get more troops if you selected tanks, for example, but you will get always more troops if you selected here rangers, because you will have, if you level up that building, you will get one more ranger in your squad. So it is very important also to upgrade these buildings. It is next in my order that I told you to upgrade. But for example, it costs a lot, but it is very important. Then after you upgrade all these buildings, this building, this building, this building, research building, war factory building, and troops, then you can focus on upgrade other buildings. And if you attacking players a lot, then you will have a lot resources, so then focus to upgrade your supply, stockpile, storage buildings, to upgrade them first. You really don't need to upgrade if you attack players all the time. You do not really to upgrade resources, buildings, almost at all. You do not need to upgrade. Most important is to upgrade these buildings that give you oil, because you will need oil for attacking other players. Then what I wanted more to tell you, yes. Yeah, so focus after upgrade all those buildings like this and this for factory command points, I advise you to focus on defense buildings and upgrade them to highest level. And first of all, upgrade artillery buildings, because most players will attack you from ground troops, and artillery buildings are the strongest against other troops, ground troops. Then what I wanted more to tell you, so, for example, in this part, you can choose what weapons you want to use to defend your base. I advise you to use only this one. But if you get higher level, for example, higher level, then you can combine. So, for example, just have a few of these and one of these, because this one is only good against aerial defense. So this one is proven the one of the strongest defense building against ground troops. So I advise you to unlock this all the time. And if you are higher level, then you will get more use of this upgrade, but do not have all of them, just one or two, and dress to be like this. Okay. Because it doesn't, not many people attack you with air, with drones and helicopters and such air units. Okay, what I wanted more to tell you. Just a second to see on my paper. Then something very important is to request defense. To request troops from your allies in your clan. It is very, very important to you request as much as you can defense. And very something very important, do not use these reinforcements in battle against other players. Not even if you are going to lose that battle, I advise you to do not use those reinforcements, because those reinforcements will be used if you do not use them, and you leave them at like this at your base and do not use them in battles. Those reinforcements will be engagement in defending your base. And mostly people, if you are especially started this game, you will not be so strong, and most your in your clan members, your clan friends in your clan, most of them are stronger level than you, and they will send you stronger troops than you can build. So if they send you reinforcements, any reinforcements will be good, except this robotics, I mean, or this practically not too much big use of it, but it can also be useful. So they will send you troops that is a lot stronger than yours. And so players that attack you will be very, very hard to defeat you if you have those reinforcements. So always do not use reinforcements in battles, even if you're going to lose battle. Don't worry, if you lose battle, you can always attack other players and get resources. So it is very important to do not use reinforcements in battles and just leave them to defend your base. Okay, also you can ask your clan mates what defense you want today send you. Just click here, for example, let's click here. I want to dismiss. Yes, come on. So when you send reinforcements, to click send me reinforcements, there is where you can type message. So you can type message, I need those reinforcements, special reinforcements, please send me strikers, please send me drones, please send me rangers. So you can just type what troops you want today send you. Okay, so that is it. I already made too much big this video, just to see on my paper if I didn't miss something for this video. Okay, that would be it for this video. I think this tips and tricks will be useful and helpful for you. It is not so complicated, this game. It is very easily to learn and very addictive. Also, you can upgrade, if you have a lot of resources, you can upgrade the walls. But I didn't see so much big difference from higher level walls. But if you have a lot of resources and you do not know what to do with it, you can upgrade those walls. Why not, for example? Why not? Oh, yes, also, for example, I forget, this building you must upgrade at highest level, because this building give you speed up maximum how much amount of your clan mates can send you help per day. Okay, that would be it. I hope this video will be useful and helpful for you. Don't forget to play this game on your mobile device, because who knows what will gonna happen with progress on Facebook game room. And I hope so, I will make more videos about this great game with some more other tips and tricks. Check my other videos of this game where I describe you totally different tips and tricks. There is special video how to successfully attack almost any player and how to successfully defend your base as much as you can successfully. And also my review of this game, my first video of this game review, is also full of tips and tricks, but mostly for beginners in this game. Okay, that would be it for this video. I really hope so you enjoyed and find it useful and helpful, this video, and see you next videos. Bye.